Hello guys and welcome to a brand new video. Today I'm here with Demon Slayer, the Entertainment District arc, episode number 2. Alright, the previous episode, it was a 1 hour special, and we got to see what happened in the aftermath of Rengoku's death. Tanjiro and, you know, going to the his house and actually, like, you know, telling everyone about his death. The whole thing with the Hinokami Kagura, we got a few more information about the origin of all the breathing techniques, and, you know, like, what Hinokami Kagura actually is. We got a few hints about it. It's basically the original version according to Rengoku's dad, and all the other breathing techniques have been derived from that. So that was that, and we got to see how his dad, obviously, like, and he's a broken man, and you know, even the death of his son wasn't able to, you know, like, move him at the beginning, as we saw. Like, you know, he was still, like, you know, very angry about everything, and but in, like, you know, in his heart, he felt sad, obviously, because that's his son. And we see that in the end, like, you know, him breaking down and everything, even though I don't like him that much. But he, you know, he is, like, what can I say, like, it's sad, like, you know, his life and everything, it, the way it went, and then way he lost all confidence and everything. And, like, you know, now, like, realizing that his son is here no more. Yeah, that's, like, you know, that's something. That's sad. So that was that. And the brother told, like, you know, Rengoku's brother told Tanjiro that, yeah, I'm going to help you guys out, you know, I'm going to try to find more information about Hinokami Kagura and tell you. That was that. Then we get a little training montage of 4 months, I guess, like, you know, they're, like, all training and everything. The you know, Haganezuka also comes with he's probably going to make him a new sword, all that. And we see, you know, Tanjiro training and all. We see him going and taking a request, defeating a demon very easily, all that. And then we meet Tengen Uzui, who has come here to take some, like, you know, female members, so, like, you know, probably because of some mission in the Entertainment District. And, like, they were taking Aoi, I think that was her name, away, and, you know, all that stuff. Kanao, I think I'm still mixing up their names. The girl who keeps quiet, I think her name is Kanao, wasn't it? Yeah, she stopped them, tried to stop them and everything. You know, Tanjiro and Zenitsu also comes in, stops them, and Tengen says that, okay, then you guys join me. So I'm guessing we're going to go to the Entertainment District in this episode. Let's see. And I have to say, I really like Tengen's character, you know, his personality. It's such a refreshing personality, and, you know, like, it feels like I'm going to have, like, you know, like, I'm going to really like this guy. So yeah, anyways, let's get started. Without further ado, we'll be starting episode number 2. So yeah, I'll be putting the subtitles and the timer here. Sync it to whichever is a preference, and let's get started. Okay, so here's the countdown. 3, 2, 1, go. There you go, Entertainment District. Okay, Zenitsu. Oh, they really don't understand. Wow. Whoa! Kami and Gomi. Wow. Wow. Well, he is flashy. This guy's crazy. Tanjiro asking the important questions. Yes. Oh, wow. Yes. Obviously, the god of festivals. God of stupidity. And he accepted that. Nice. Yeah, you're trash. Didn't I say you? You're... True. His facial expression. Oh, there you go. Let's go. Guys, they're falling behind. Yeah. Oh boy, this opening is so good. I love it. And I kind of noticed this, like, one of the girls, he looks like Inosuke, doesn't he? She looks like Inosuke, doesn't she? You know, the blue haired girl? Different facial expressions, kind of. I doubt they're related, but still, you know, I'm just saying their appearances kind of match. Oh my god, I love Aimer, you know. And Mike, Inosuke really looks good in, you know, in the opening. Like the dress, the way she, like, you know, the dress that she's wearing. I think this season is going to have 12 or 11 episodes, something like that. So I don't know, like, I feel like, but you know what, like, Mugen Rashan was completed in 7 episodes, so it is possible, I guess, to complete this arc. I'm not even sure if this, like, you know, this season will be the end of this arc or they're going to continue to the next season. But yeah, anyways, let's watch. Infiltrating the entertainment district. Okay. Wow. Okay. All right. Yeah. But Inosuke, I don't know about Inosuke. Zenitsu, what are they doing? Inosuke's like, what is this place? Okay. Drew Yoshiwara, okay. Vanny. Yep, slashing. Scheming with people. Inosuke is getting a culture shock. Okay, calm down. He's fine, I guess. Oh my god. Yeah. Yeah. Sleep during the day and night. Okay. True. Okay. That's why. Poverty and debt. Oh, Iran. Yeah. The courtesan. Yeah. Yeah. The top, as far as I know, like the courtesans or the top oirans, they are like one of the most respected people. Yeah. Like they had to. Okay. Bride. No one's listening. No, he's talking about his wife. What? Yeah, oh my God, Zensu. That's like, oh, okay. What's that? He's still eating. Three of them. He's like, yeah, you're fantasizing. Yep. Accept it, Zenitsu. Yeah, Zenitsu. Like, I did know that those were his wives because from the trailer, from the comments, I got to know that. Disguise. Yep, cross dress. Oh, they're also ninjas. Okay. Okay, that's why they had to. Three. Suma, Makio, Inatsuru. Inosuke! Well, oh, it's, wait, what is that? What's happening? Oh, quite homely girls. They're like, oh my God. Wow, he has his head down. Turn into diamonds. Tengen, my God. Oh my God, he looks amazing. Ooh. Sumiko employed. Yes. Come on, it's a fault of the makeup. Inosuke looks, I'm sure he'll look great. No, not for that. Yeah, he's angry about something else. My God, Inosuke looks so weird. Not only he doesn't have his mask, but oh, these are the it's here. Yeah. Courtesans. তোকে তো হাউসে শোন। ওকে নো জেনিৎসু, মাই গড, ও নো, শি হার্ড দ্যাট, শি হার্ড দ্যাট, ইয়া গো অ্যাহেড। অগিমোতো হাউস, ইয়া শি ওয়ান্টস হিম, ইনোকো, I'm surprised he's actually going with her. Then it's just like, yeah, I'm the one only left. Rejected. Yep, there you go. Yes! So cheap. I think Inosuke still doesn't realize what's happening. Warabihime Koinatsu. Yeah. What's good? Okay. Yogoku House. Oh, is it Zenitsu? Wow, he plays pretty well, I think. Oh, is he sleeping? No, he's not. Oh, nice, Zenitsu, you're hired. Oh yeah, that's why. Okay. Wow. Yeah, it's Uzui. That's why he lowered his. Oh. 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 You're. I think she's right in a way, but still. She's right in a way. Free. Wow. Number one. Okay. Oh my god. This episode is hilarious. Easy. Yes, one hand. One hand is enough for this. That's why. Yeah. One hand. Okay. What? Ashinuke. What? Yeah, what's that? Oh, okay. Yeah. Uma. Oh, okay. Oh, this lady. Candy. Wow, that looks good. Well, I'm undercover. Yes. Sister. There you go. So honest, you can't assume. Okay, so diary. Wait. Oh, that's what she did. Okay. Oh. All right. Wait, is that lady? The lady we've been seeing, is she one of the demons? Go. Wait, so three different. Okay, she's there. So, see, three different ladies have gone to the three different places. Yeah. Yosuke looks great in. Yeah. Okay. Up. Yeah. Well, obviously. Yep. Whoa. Whoa, what's happening? Oh, this is one of the. Is it Suma? Is Makio? Wait. Wait. Oh, Makio's here. Okay. Oh, is this the ending? Wait, the ending is also by Aymar? I think so. This is Aymar, isn't it? Wow. Wait, is this Yuki Kajiura's? It does seem like that. The music kind of seems like that. There you go, Aymar, and the music, it feels like Yuki Kajiura's music. I might be wrong though. Oh. That scene. That was a master, wasn't it? Yep, this ending has full on Kaano Kyokai vibes. Kaano Kyokai and UFO Type Moon vibes. So I'm guessing this is Yuki Kajiura's song. Oh my god, that was beautiful. Oh, there's still left. Yes. Okay. Mirror. Mirror. Hands in the mirror. Oh my god. Okay, that was the end. Wow. Okay. I was really looking forward to this episode because seeing them infiltrating the entertainment district was something I was really waiting for. My god. And yeah, this was amazing. Okay, first of all, we get to know about Tengen's three wives. Now, as I said, I already knew that these three were actually his wives because in the trailer they were also shown. And from the comment section I was able to know that these three were actually his wives. So that was not something shocking, and yeah, I kind of knew that. So yeah, that's that. Now, here's the thing. I did not know they were actually here in the entertainment district. Already infiltrated, and they're trying to find out stuff, more clues about the demons and everything. And Uzui is basically he tried to do this, but unfortunately he wasn't able to go much further because he came as customers, but as customers it's pretty difficult to actually get to know about these rumors, but if you are like one of the inner members, or if you're one of the courtesans, or one of the staff members, then you'll be able to hear a lot of things. And usually in this entertainment district, as far as I know, information is can be gotten. Like, there's a lot of information that you can get which you might not even be able to know by any other means. Because a lot of people come here, and it's kind of like a tavern, I have to say. In a tavern, as you've seen in animes and RPGs, if you want to get information, where do you go? To the tavern. Because there will be a lot of people eating, drinking, and they'll be talking, gossiping and all stuff. So you can hear a lot of things in a tavern. And obviously the bartender is the biggest information source. Like, if you pay them a little bit of money or something, they'll give you all the information that you need to. According to anime. So just like that, I guess entertainment district is also some place like that. And as Uzui said, this is probably the best place for demons because this is a place which is alive at night but goes to sleep in the morning. So perfect for demons. And yeah, so we get to the entertainment district, and obviously As I said, like, you know, I obviously have not much information about this, like, you know, the whole entertainment district or Yukaku, as they say. But as all, like, you know, all the information that I know about this is from different other animes, games, visual novels as I've played. And like, obviously, I know like there is a different, like, you know, different types of like courtesans here who are like one of the most, I guess, like, you know, like as we saw that lady in the middle, who was kind of going and everyone was following her. She I'm guessing she's one of the higher ranking members, and like as they call her a courtesan. And as a courtesan, as they said, they have to learn a lot of things. For example, I'm guessing, like, you know, T what do you call them? I'm forgetting the names. I forgot the name. What's the name of flower arrangement? You know, there's a particular name for flower arrangement. I can't remember the name, but anyways, you know, flower arrangement, like, you know, pouring tea, a lot of other arts and everything. Even I think even different games and everything, you know, like for example, shogi and stuff. Like, they have to learn a lot of different instruments. They have to learn different instruments and, like, you know, etiquette and proper manners, everything. This dancing, yeah, dancing. And all this stuff, like you know, they need to get trained, and they are like one of the most respected people of other places. And like, as Tengen said, they basically run the reins of a family, you know, and that's why, you know, like they are very much respected in this place, and they're like courtesans. They're the, like, you know, the topmost people. And as we saw, you know, like there's like usually like one of the bigger leaders, and there are a lot of other people who accompany them. For example, we saw those two little kids who were accompanying the other lady, you know, and all that stuff. Now, as I said, like everything I've learned about, I know about this is from different animes and games. Like, I'm a huge fan of Gintama, and Gintama in itself has like a huge part of it happening in the whole entertainment district of Kabukicho. And you know, the whole Sukuyo arc and everything is completely, like, you know, related to the entertainment district. And that's why I'm a bit accustomed to this. I know what I usually, like, you know, happens and what it is about. But as I said, like, you know, everything is like my information about everything is from anime. So there might be stuff that I won't be able to understand or, like, you know, realize. But yeah. Anyways, so yeah, we get here and they put up makeup and cross dress. I don't know who gave them the makeup, but I'm guessing it's probably Tengen, because that makeup was bad. That was a very bad makeup that they did on them. That's why everyone was like, oh, like they're ugly. We won't, like, you know, we're not supposed to take them. Like, we can't take them. But obviously Tengen, you know, he had his hair just flowing around. You know, just like, like, you know, like all dressed up and everything. He was there, and looking at him, everyone was like, yeah, we'll take them. My God, that was so easy for them to actually get in. I was surprised, like, obviously, because of Tengen, everyone just took So. Yeah, it was funny to see all the different, like, you know, characters, how they actually reacted to that. This Tanjiro was like, okay, like, you know what, yeah, this is like a mission, I'm going to do this, you know, like straightforward and simple. Inosuke really wasn't able to understand what the hell was happening, because he basically went with the lady, and when, like, you know, they dressed him up, he was still unable to understand what was happening. He was like, huh, what's happening? Why am I here? And then later on, he was able to realize, you know. And even though Tengen did tell him that don't use your voice, you're going to give yourself up. And obviously, no one took Zenitsu was like, you know, like no one was taking him, but by the end of it, someone did take him because of obviously Tengen. And Zenitsu was like, I'm going to be the number one Oiran in this entertainment district, and I'll show Tengen, you know, I'll show him. Oh my God, wow, that was fantastic. So everyone's doing their part. And now here's the thing. So as far as I can understand, the different like you know the ladies, the three wives, each of them are like in a separate like you know like place. And for example, the people who took the Tanjiro, I think Suma, that was the name, or what was the name of Tengen's wife? Just a sec. Suma. Yeah, there you go. Suma Wiran. So Suma. Suma is like the place that took Tanjiro. Here Suma was here. The place that took Inosuke, Makio is there. And I'm not sure if the place where they took Zenitsu has the other lady. But I'm guessing it's probably going to be something like that. But you know what? We'll see. So Suma was here at least in the place where they took Tanjiro, and she it said that she ran away because like you know to like what did they call that? What was the term that they just a sec. Ashinuke, yeah. Not repaying their debts and running away. And Ashinuke, that whole thing. So Tanjiro, like you know, starts asking questions. That really what she did. Now, I thought that she did that because you know she probably got some information about demons, that's why she like you know went away from here. But it turns out Tanjiro is thinking about this in a different way. Tanjiro says that the one who put that letter there was some other person, you know, and it's probably a demon because you know demon like that person wants to corner her or something, and that's why like you know that's why they use the letter. Now here's the thing, the lady who we were talking to here, the Oiran, the courtesan, I don't know, it seems I'm not sure if that lady is a demon or not. I might be completely wrong, but you know, like the way this is kind of going, I won't be surprised if she actually turns out to be a demon in disguise. And you know, because she is here, and as Tanjiro kind of is speculating that someone must have put the faked letter there, maybe this lady is a demon and she's the one who actually kind of did this. But I might be completely wrong though, you know. And yeah, like we'll have to wait because I do know there is one demon who will be one of the courtesans, as we see in the opening, you know, and the trailers that we've also seen, like this one of the courtesans who is a demon. So that's what I'm thinking, like maybe this is the same girl, I'm not sure, but you know, like it won't surprise me. Because obviously there are definitely demons who are disguised as human within this entertainment district. That's one thing that I'm pretty sure. And yeah, now here's the thing. There's another thing that actually makes me suspicious. I'm talking about the scene where Tengen is kind of on top of the roofs and he's like you know looking at everything and he's like you know seeing. And then they show us a scene where there is a courtesan walking, you know, down the corridor, and there are two little girls with her. And so we don't properly get to see her face here. But just a second, let me check if this girl that we see, who they're implying to be a demon, and the girl who Tanjiro met are same or not. I don't think. No, they're different. They're different. I can see that now. You know why? Because of her hair ornament. Just a sec. Let me check that scene again. Okay. So here it is. Again, I'm seeing that. They're showing that lady kind of walking down the corridor. They're not showing her face. I'm guessing this girl is the demon. Now here's it. I feel like this scene was may showed to us to make us a little bit suspicious of the other girl, who Tanjiro was talking with. Because, that girl was also accompanied by two little kids. And here we also see them, and it would actually, I won't be surprised if a lot of people think that these two ladies are the same. But I think they're different because of the hair ornaments. Here we get a closer view of her face. We don't get a view of her face. Her face is kind of in shadows. The person who is probably the demon, we do see her ornaments, hair ornaments. It's not it's a like the shape is like this, this and this. This type of a shape. While the other lady in front of Tanjiro, yeah, her hair ornaments are completely different. It's a circle. So those two are different. So as I was saying, I'm a little bit suspicious of this lady who was with Tanjiro. That negates my suspicion. This lady is not the demon. But she might have changed her hair ornaments. That might also be the case. But I don't think this lady is the demon. So here it is. My conclusion: this lady is not the demon. The one who we saw in the end was someone who is different from this lady. It's probably someone else, and that girl is the demon. That lady is the demon. So yeah, I feel that's what is happening. Because I have to be honest here, I was a little bit suspicious of that girl with Tanjiro, who was talking about Suma and saying that, oh, these might be rumors. And as Tanjiro kind of comes into a conclusion that, yeah, this might be a work of a demon. So I was a little bit suspicious of this lady at the beginning, because I thought maybe she's the demon who actually trapped Suma somewhere or something. But the last scene confirms that no, she's not the demon, because this demon, supposedly the demon that we are being shown in the end, is someone who's completely different from this girl. So yeah, that's just my guess. Anyways, so that's one thing that's happening. Suma's missing. We don't know where she is. And Makio, I think she has been captured. Not captured, but she's being kept under constraints and in Inosuke's place. And they found out that she is writing the letters to someone. Okay, okay, yeah. The person who is keeping her under constraints, I don't think they showed us her face. Let's see. There are I don't know what those are, clothing pieces or dress pieces, and it's kind of constraining her hands. Yeah, they're not showing her face. I'm talking about the demon. It's probably a demon who's keeping her captive. Okay. So Makio and the demon is probably with in Inosuke's place. I'm not sure about Tanjiro's place, what's happening, but in Tanjiro's place there is Suma was there. And the other lady, we have no clue where she is. So that's like the basic summary of this episode. And Tengen is also keeping an eye out on everything. Probably in the next episode, we're going to see Inosuke trying to go to the room where Makio is supposedly there. And yeah, maybe we'll get some information about Suma and the other lady who we still don't have any idea where she is. So yeah, so that was it. That was this episode. Okay, so that was this episode. This was episode number 2 of Demon Slayer: The Entertainment District arc. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to press the like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel. Or you haven't subscribed, and comment down below anything you want to say, anything you want to let me know, and I'll check them out. And as I said, I might make mistakes and everything. I might not be able to understand a few things because this whole entertainment district arc will probably have a lot of things which non-Japanese people won't have any idea about. And as I said, all my knowledge and information that I kind of know about this is from other animes and games, visual novels that I've played, so it might not be completely correct. So if I've made some wrong assumptions or something made a mistake or something, understood something wrongly, definitely correct me down in the comment section. I'll check them out. So yeah, that's it, guys. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next week with another episode of Demon Slayer Entertainment District Arc. So until then, goodbye and have a nice day.